Today is a very special day in Ultimo Stele history, because I'm, for the last time ever, hopefully, starting this engine in the car. And when I get the car back, it'll have the perfect race engine, sports car engine, that I've been planning for years. Steffen is finally all finished with the engine, and I'm driving across the country to hand in the car for final assembly. And it's been a long story, and I like to tell it in detail one day. It's a very complicated video, but I've actually been here at this point earlier. Some years ago, I actually did hand in the car and I did get the new engine, and it ran okay, and then it blew during tuning. So this is, as I said, a complicated case. But I'll do my best to explain. First of all, let's drive over to the good man and let him fiddle with the car. I need to split this into a few videos. In this first one, I'll explain about the different engines that has been fitted to my car, to my knowledge. So that was 2 hours of plain driving with earplugs, and now I'm here. So first of all, let me repeat some facts about my car. It's produced in 1962. It's a Giulietta Sprint Normale, a Tipo 101.02. The chassis number is 350886. And the Carrozzeria Bertone number is 652-4545. So this series 350 was a special batch that Alfa Romeo made during that year. There were 975 cars, of which 161 were Veloce cars. And they were made in order to satisfy a need in the market for junior cars, really, while everybody was waiting for the Giulia, the 105 series Bertone model. So this is also why the car would have come out of the factory in 1962, with an AR00102 engine. Somebody must have imported this car to Denmark specifically, because back then there were no real dealerships for Alfa Romeo cars in this country. So the owner bought it in 1962 and drove it until the middle of the 70s, 75. Then somebody bought the car and used it for their wedding and had the car for a couple of years, and then it was decommissioned, still having the same engine, presumably. Then I know for a fact, from some racing papers, that it had an AR00526 engine, engine number 28783. This would have been from a Giulia Super 1967. But when I bought the car, it had an AR00536, engine number 06406. And this would have been from a Giulia Sprint GT Veloce, 1966.
The previous owners raced it with this engine in the Danish series. They were allowed to use the 1600 engine because of the general confusion about Alfa Romeo cars, I think. It also had disc brakes at one point. But when I bought it, I decided to bring it back to Sprint Veloce 1959 spec.
So I went and got myself a 1.3-liter Alfa engine.
The only engine I could find was from a 1.3 GT Junior. It was engine number AR00530S2497, and this would have been from 1974. It was a modern type Series 105 engine, and this is the engine that Stefan and I modified over a couple of years, some years back. It eventually crashed, and I'll show some details about how that engine was built. Then began the agonizing job of finding the reason for the failure, and we transplanted the 00536 1600 engine back in the car. And this is the engine I've been running with until 2020. Then I got an opportunity to build a new engine, still a 1300, trying to make a proper Sprint Veloce spec car.
And we found ourselves a new block.
We sourced engine number AR00102-24753. This would have been out of a Giulietta Sprint or Giulietta Spider Normale from 1961. And we actually went a long way with an engine builder or a machinist shop before they found out that there were some faults in the block. So we had to abandon that. And Stefan has actually now sourced another block, and this is the block that he's installing in the car now with all our development work included. And this engine is number 1315, meaning that it's a Tipo 750 engine, number 30558. And this number actually is from an original series of Veloce engines. It must be from 1957, and it was either in a Giulietta Sprint Veloce or a Giulietta Spider Veloce. And that's very interesting, because now I'll have a chassis number from a Normale 102 from that special series in 1962, and the engine number in all my papers will show that it's a proper Veloce engine. Well, window dressing, you could say, but I think it's very important, and there's a lot of culture in all these numbers.
So, mission accomplished until now. I have the car. Right there. So, in the near weeks, it'll be fixed. And I'm looking forward to actually more using it next year. But looks good. Agree? Next time.